the word derived from two separate words, like pathos and logos. This is study of disease. Pathology is basically devoted to the study of the structural, biochemical, and functional changes in the cells, tissues, and organs that underlie disease. So here we learn about the disease with the help of these techniques, like molecular techniques, microbiological techniques, immunological techniques, and with all this we can explain why the signs and symptoms are manifested by the patient, and thereby that helps to provide a rational basis for the clinical care and therapy. Basically, pathology is a paradigm system which acts as a bridge between the basic science and clinical medicine, and it's a scientific basis for all of the medicine. So there are two classifications of pathology. One is general pathology, systemic pathology. General pathology is concerned with the reactions of cells and tissues to abnormal stimuli, anti-integrative defects, which are the main cause of disease. It's a generalized study of the tissues and cells to the abnormal stimuli. Whereas the system pathology examines alterations, specialized organs and tissues, which are responsible for the disorders that involve these organs. So when we learn disease, these four aspects are dealt with. One is etiology, that is the cause of disease, the main cause, what is the cause, and the mechanism of development of the disease, that is the pathogenesis. The biochemical and structural alterations induced in the cells and organs of the body, like molecular and morphologic changes, and the functional consequences of these changes, that is the clinical manifestations. These are the four aspects of disease that we need. So to start with cellular adaptation, we have to first know about what is homeostasis. So normal cell is confined to a fairly narrow range of function and structure by state of metabolism, differentiation, specialization, by constraints of neighboring cells, and by availability of metabolic substrates. The maintenance of steady state is known as homeostasis. Thus, the adaptations are just a small deviation from happens when the homeostasis is disturbed. These are purely reversible, maybe functional or maybe structural responses to more severe physiologic stresses and some pathologic stimuli, during which a new but steady state is achieved so that the cell will continue to survive and function. So this is a flowchart which shows the things that happens to a cell, the events that happen to a cell for the